everyone to the Wake Up Call channel. Joe Biden has dropped out of the selection November 5th, 2024, with only a few months or close to 100 days remaining before Big Brother decides who our next president is going to be. Then, of course, tells you that you made the decision and that you're responsible for the chaos to come. But Joe Biden dropping out of the election doesn't change anything, for me at least, as far as the outcome of this selection goes, because the outcome is going to be the same. It's going to be predetermined, and it's going to cause order out of chaos. So by them having Joe Biden drop out this far along, with only 100 days or so until this fake election occurs, is a very nice plot twist for the reality show, which is really just getting more unbelievable by the second. The way that this thing swings and the way that this seesaw goes, I mean, it's literally like watching a movie, because it is, of course, because this entire thing is theatrics. It's theatrical. And at the end of this production, the outcome is going to be a hand-chosen person. Now, if it fits either way with either candidate, there will be chaos that comes. But before I get into the candidates, remember this other narrative that has been floating out there for years now. Even this year at the World Economic Forum, they talked about election disruption from AI. And we have all been groomed since 2016 with election denied. Now, we all know that the election is not real. Most of you who are awake have known this for a long time. This is an illusion of freedom. This is an illusion of you picking the person that's put in power. They are hand-selected. But over the last 8 years, since Trump ran against Hillary Clinton, we have heard the Democrats say that the election was rigged one way. And then now, with Biden, we heard conservatives say that the election was rigged one way. And this is delivered. This narrative is out there deliberately. Not of a fake election, of a rigged election. And of course, the World Economic Forum has openly talked about this as well, how AI is going to, in the future, dictate the outcome of elections. And people out there don't realize they're being groomed into that. What does technology tell us? Would suit us best? Who would be the best candidate, right? That's why you always hear about these polls where technology runs tests, right? Where, you know, football teams, who's going to win the Super Bowl? Well, we ran a simulation 1,000 times. Well, we did this. Eventually, they're just going to be out in the open and tell you that technology and AI is going to determine your next president or your next prime minister, your global president, based on what is needed and what is best for everyone. But here it is, Klaus Schwab again talking about how in the future you will be able to tell us.
The digital technologies mainly have an analytical power. Now we go into a predictive power, and we have seen the first examples, and your company very much involved into it. But such an extent could be to go into prescriptive mode, which means you do not even have to have elections anymore, because you can already predict, and afterwards you can say, why do we need elections? Because we know what the result will be. The technology now is, and the digital technologies mainly have an analytical power. Now we go.
So in order for that to become a reality, there has to be a major, major, major event that occurs around the election, like nobody believing the actual outcome of the election. And the way the momentum is going with Donald Trump, whoever is put in last minute, it's going to be very hard for people to actually swallow the pill that is given to them come November 5th. Now, let's look at some of the narratives that are out there in regards to this. And remember, when I'm talking about the infrastructure collapsing, right? Deliberate sabotage is a common theme that you see going on. The infrastructure is being sabotaged. That means that elections, as you know, are going to be sabotaged. And this will also be tied into the digital ID. Voting, as you know, it will no longer be the same way after this fake election on November 5th. So one of the things that's trending, which everyone needs to pay attention to before I go through each candidate, is Democrats tweeting out, vote blue no matter what. Vote blue no matter what. That's what America, this republic, has come to, right? But conservatives don't realize they do the same thing. They will vote red no matter what, right? They're loyal to their party, which is why I talk about dual communism all the time. So the Democrats are tweeting out, our goal remains the same. Keep Trump out of the White House. Vote blue no matter what. And Joe Biden has endorsed Kamala Harris as the next president, but that doesn't mean anything, because there's plenty of time before the Democratic National Convention where they announce the nominee, which is part of the theater of all this, right? You know, during the Republican National Convention, a few days ago, we actually have to wait for them to announce Donald Trump at the Republican National Convention on stage, so they all think, oh, yes, they've just chosen him, okay, so it's not really true, but we already knew that. This is going to be a seesaw again with Kamala Harris and these other candidates that I'll mention. So, what the media is reporting is that Kamala Harris has been endorsed by Joe Biden, and they're talking about the potential running mate, of course, Pete Buttigieg is one of the nominees, another one of these that fits them very well, but they're confident who's sabotaged for one of these positions, of course, because of the DEI nonsense that they push, that they want to deserve to scale and cancel it. Have absolutely no skill set whatsoever, only based on their preferences or their skin color. So Buttigieg is one of the names, and of course Gavin Newsom is the other. I've covered him many times over the years. He's the ultimate sleazeball salesman. He plays the role very well of the smooth human being. Of course, not really the opposite. Any sign of Gavin Newsom in this will just be nauseating for me personally, having to cover this guy on a day and day basis with the big election coming up. But then we get the two big candidates, right? The two obvious ones that everybody's thinking, at least one of them is pretty obvious. The other one might come out of right field. I'm sure most of you have already seen it trending, and you've seen some of the stuff out there floating around, and it would make the most sense for a WrestleMania type of scenario here, because again, this is a stage, this wrestling literally is starting to look like we're gonna have a WrestleMania type main event on November 5th. But the obvious one that everyone's talking about is, wait a minute, I think I hear a theme song. I think I'm Mike. So that's the obvious one, right? Everybody over the last couple of years has talked about Big Mike getting put in this position. So it could be another term for Barry Sortero. That's a mainstream type of narrative that all conservatives constantly spew, right? They think that Obama himself is the one who's pulling all the strings, instead of just all of these globalists together doing it. They don't need Michelle Obama. People to pull their hair out of the most chaos. And if we're going to divide the United States of America, which I still believe, that's my personal opinion based on all the predictive programming that I've seen over the last decade, is that they're planning on dividing us into two separate countries. I know it's hard to accept right now, and I know a lot of people believe it right now. That's just my take. I could be wrong about that. But if we're going to talk about who would cause the most chaos, who would be the biggest headliner on the ticket versus Donald Trump? Because let's be real. The stuff with Biden over the last couple of months has grown boring. The theatrics of it all has gotten boring. It's not even as theatrical as it once was. But who would make people feel the most? Hillary Clinton. And that's not a name coming out of right field, because, of course, InfoWars and Alex Jones have been talking about over the last 24 hours or so that inside sources, Alex Jones has telling that Hillary Clinton, out of nowhere, would be the candidate for the Democratic National Party, right? For the Democrats, it would be
God is the source, right, Alex Jones, who said that Biden would drop out by July 20th and he nailed it again. God is my source. A lot of these people like to prophesize themselves and say that God is the source. I don't know if God is coming down to Alex Jones to tell him in the night that Joe Biden dropped out of the race. I mean, some of the stuff these people say that everyone goes, God, where'd you drop? Yeah, God, I know the God, you know, I read in the Bible about prophets and visions for prophets and Daniel and all, everything in the Bible. I don't know if God's coming down to tell him that Joe Biden's going to drop out of a date on this day or that day or this person's going to be put in. But of course, everything we've seen with divine intervention in that theme, we can clearly see if you're awake and paying attention, that they're baiting Christians like never before. So Alex Jones naturally is going to be one of the people that bait Christians by saying that God told them. And if we're going to go by this narrative, then it might actually look like Hillary Clinton would in fact be the choice. Wouldn't that be the perfect choice? Because this has been an 8-year buildup between the two, right? Draining the swamp. This would be the most WWF theme they could possibly do to put at the end of all this stuff that's happened. It all started in 2016. You know, when Obama was in power, a lot of our rights were getting signed away. But the theatrics of it all, the absolute just insanity of it all, started with Hillary versus Trump. It became a spectacle. You got an actor, you know, a reality TV star running against someone who everybody openly knows is a witch, right? Who's saying all these things that they're putting out in the open about Bohemian Grove. It makes the perfect sense, right? The ultimate witch versus the guy that they're putting out there trying to be betrayed as a prophet, as somebody chosen by God. It's political theater 101. If that's the route they go, I don't know what route they could go. But to me, that does make the most sense at this point, because Hillary Clinton or Michael Obama would be the two that would incite the most out of Republicans. But Hillary, 10 times more than Big Mike. Big Mike makes people out there snicker. The whole notion of it, obviously, because Big Mike over the next couple of months, all you'll hear is everybody talking about, well, Big Mike, and how Mike is, you know, disaster whatever, right? That's what you would hear. But with Hillary, that would cause the most chaos, because people will be feeling it. If Alex Jones is tweeting that out as a COINTELPRO agent, then we should probably look at it and say there's a good chance, because then Alex Jones can come out and say, Alex Jones, he's writing that. Where's he getting his information? Well, from God, they tell us, right? But really, he's getting his information, obviously, from the inside, because it's on the inside. Now, if they choose it, the next few months will be chaotic, because again, you're going to have this theme of a prophet, and chosen by God, and Christians are getting more riled up, and they're going to bring back up all of this stuff with Hillary Clinton, her email stuff that she said in interviews. You know, I mean, it's all legit with Hillary Clinton, you know, stuff that's out there, okay? As far as, you know, when Hillary Clinton's involved, you know, we can recap the Ryan's book, Transformation of America, to see some of the more disgusting details that came out way before Hillary Clinton was running for the president of the United States back in 2016. And again, in that book, there's a lot of names mentioned who are doing all that stuff with children who are still floating around now, like Lee Greenwood, or Greenwald, the guy who says that God bless the USA that Trump rules out all the time, and that's that Bible that he's trying to sell, right? Lee Greenwood, I believe his name is. So this is where we're headed, right? I mean, as if it couldn't already be more scripted, it couldn't be more ridiculous. You got an assassination attempt, you got a guy falling downstairs with Alzheimer's, you got another guy who's talking about Project 25 and not talking about pretending he's not going to do all these things in Project 25, which would infringe on all of our rights, not just Democrats, all of the stuff. I mean, if you're young, you think that this is normal. If you're older, you know that this isn't normal. This is not the way that politics has ever gone before. But the people out there think that this is the way that it goes, because people have short-term memory. A lot of that's obviously the 5G, the cell phones on their head or in their pocket 24/7. But a lot of them don't even start to think to themselves for 5 seconds about this isn't normal for things to be going like this. This isn't normal with, you know, these candidates being so unhinged one way versus the other way, right? And of course, like I said earlier in the video, like the motto is for them, order out of chaos is the name of the game. Whatever will cause the most order out of chaos is likely to be the script that they follow. I believe that it was Biden that was going to stay in there, but the more I think about this with the name Hillary floated around, because that wasn't really a name you heard too much anymore. But when Jones started talking about that, it started to make sense. Because if you're looking at this from a theater standpoint, in Acts, right, Act 1, Act 2, and Act 3 of a movie, well, the first act started with these two, right? And then the act with Biden in the middle of the ups and downs, and now for a climax that would cause utter chaos, because if they put Hillary Clinton, as president, with 100 days left, right, with 100 days to go, all the stuff that we've been gaslit with since 2016, if they put her in versus winning Biden, think about how much more chaos would ensue. That might be the straw that breaks the camel's back, so to speak, where people would separate. Because I don't think Republicans would remain in this country with Hillary Clinton as the president. And I think what would happen is everybody would question the outcome, because all we've heard over the last couple of weeks specifically is that this thing is over, that Donald Trump is going to win. That's what we heard in 2022. I talked about that when I covered the red wave of the primaries. I talked about how expect the opposite. Always expect the opposite, because that's how they really create order out of chaos, and they nuke your mind with this stuff. Everybody out there would expect that Hillary versus Trump, that Trump will win in a slam dunk. And of course, if Hillary somehow wins this time in the final lap, that'll be the final straw. And conservatives will say, we can't remain here anymore. But Trump will come out and say, it's clearly rigged. It's 100% rigged. It's arch nemesis. It's not Joe Biden. It's arch nemesis Hillary Clinton, if you look at it from a political theater standpoint. So if somehow, after the last time they claimed that Trump rigged it with Russia, that Hillary does it this time and somehow wins, all these people will say that she fully rigged it, the Democrats rigged it, the deep state rigged it, they tried to assassinate him. That's it. We've had enough. And then Trump can come out and he can start talking to other, you know, you'll see from conservative governors, etc., like we saw the whispers with Texas and the border, how they talk about separating from the Union. If Hillary wins, and all these narratives out, Trump's gonna win in a landslide, that would cause the most order out of chaos. But again, even if they put Donald Trump in power, which I don't believe they would, because I don't think it's likely for Democrats to be, you know, to move around the way they want to move them around, because they're more likely to just complain about it than actually take action. I think conservatives would have enough and they would follow it. You know, all this stuff with the assassination, you can see how these people literally think God is intervening here, which is part of the narrative. And if Donald Trump doesn't win, right, obviously, if Donald Trump isn't selected, these people become unhinged. They will become unhinged. If Donald Trump comes out and says it's rigged, and we need to separate, and the conservative governors and senators all come on board and say, hey, you know what? Yeah, something's not right with this, or there's rumors of collusion, and there's news stories about this, and the Democrats always hide stuff with the, you know, Department of Justice, the FBI working for them, and all this stuff with Hunter Biden's laptop. We can't do this anymore. We can't live among each other anymore. That would probably be, again, the final straw. The final countdown is on, ladies and gentlemen, for this absolute charade, sham of an election, where people should see this and realize that this is real. This is what politics are. They're so emotionally invested in this. It's going to be crazy to watch how this stuff plays out. And I don't really like to cover the political stuff. I know a lot of you don't really like to cover it. It's hard not to, because we're watching so many people around us affected by it. And me personally, seeing how many Christians are affected by it, I'm not going to lie. It bothers me a lot. Not the same way that they support, you know, Donald Trump, the way that they support, how defensive they are, somebody they don't know, how they're blaspheming God's name by saying that God's intervening and, you know, intercepting bullets, right? Like I made the comparison of watching a movie. In a movie, you know, when a hero survives some, you know, climactic event at the end of the movie, the people stand up and say, God intervened. That's a movie, right? Well, that's exactly what you're seeing play out. And there should be more evidence of the seesaw continues. People are going to become more unhinged. If Jones is right with Hillary, or possibly with Big Mike. The reason I don't think it's Big Mike is because it's more of a laughable narrative. You know, I mean, I can see them getting angry over time. I think at first they would laugh. But Hillary involves a lot of anger and a lot of people. And there's all those things floating around with the Bohemian Grove and the Moloch emails, the spirit cooking emails. That goes back to my beginnings here on this platform. I mean, another YouTuber's beginnings on this platform. I'm Wake Up Call. But that's how I started. You know, that year I started. I didn't start with that specific topic. But, you know, towards the end of the year, I was drawn into that because of the stuff that was going on with those emails and that pizza part, right? And we were getting gaslit by a lot of the information that was getting leaked. But like I talked about then, all the stuff we were finding on this guy's Instagram account, the Freemasonic Lodge. I mean, it was frightening. And the Hillary Foundation, of course, this stuff is not, you know, this isn't a secret. I'm pretty sure the Democrats at this point know Bill and Hillary Clinton's involvement in a trafficking game, okay, and they just disregard it. They don't care. Kind of like how conservatives disregard the connection they constantly see with Donald Trump and Epstein and all these other people. They just, they don't seem to care because they love the candidate so much. That's, again, dual communism. They love